We are so close to football. I can fucking smell it, dude.
That, and we're like, yeah. And the cool thing is, to the people that listen and watch, we stay on a schedule. Like, we're on
drink schedule.
Like, people in Hollywood would love us. The budget would never be extended because, like, we always, you know, we're always on time. We do these one, you know, we do two a week.
Yep, two a week. We're like the Marines of podcasters.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm on that strict of a schedule.
Yeah. And that's where, I mean, I was going to do this one shirtless, but you know what I mean? I don't want to
make you guys feel all fired up. Yeah.
Well, Mo, yeah, that's true.
We don't want viewers that are just here for, you know, you shirtless. We want them here for the content too. You know, the sports stuff.
We could get, I mean, well, all right, fuck it, dude.
Yeah. You got your own OnlyFans for that. You know?
Yeah, no, and it's
there you go. Ass, there you by go. The way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you want to plug it, you know, that's your call.
Yeah, it's arms at arms 69. I don't even know how do you come up with it? Is that it?
That's it. Probably work
arms 69. Arms 69.
Maybe use a 4 for the A just to make sure the account isn't taken.
That's what I usually Well, no, they actually gave it to me when they saw my pictures because they were like, dude, nobody else is worthy. They were like, There was a guy that had it, but they, you know what I mean?
It's kind of like that other Beers and Bets podcast that we just ran out of town.
Yeah, we do.
Last season. Man.
Yeah, they like four episodes doing it. They did.
Yeah.
We're still getting the hate mail from them, man, because they know, dude, again, like our consistency is what makes us really powerful and like this networking and everything. So I want to say cheers to you boys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
It's good to be back.
Cheers to the fact that we're getting really close to fucking NFL, man. It's almost August.
Yep. We are going to talk some football today. Second part of this episode. But I want to start off with baseball because we just finished All-Star break and the Home Run Derby. And I need you guys to fill me in here on what's going on with this Juan Soto guy. The Nats don't fly him home from the Home Run Derby. The Nats don't want to give him a contract.
I like what you did there. Nats
and
don't fly
him. Here's what I want to talk about too, other than just strictly the Juan Soto stuff. In baseball, like a team like the Nationals was in the World Series like two seasons ago, right? When Harper was still there and they had
I have a feeling
they had 19? Scherzer and they won the other 19? Pitcher.
Yeah.
I'm forgetting.
I have a feeling
Strasburg,
I know where this road is.
Strasburg. Yeah.
I know where this boat's going.
Yeah, like how does a team fall apart that bad? Is ownership in baseball just that important that teams like the Nationals and the Royals, like 6-7 years back, they can win a World Series and just completely fall off because ownership doesn't want to pay the young guys? Well, is that really? Is
it kind of? The owners being stubborn, no?
Right, well, I mean, and the owners want out now for the Nationals, so that really doesn't help.
They're selling the team.
You're trying to sell the team. You don't want to pay a guy. You know, commit 400, what, probably 500 million to them and then say, oh yeah, but we're going to sell it to you now. It's not our problem. You know, plus they fucked up. They didn't want to re-sign Scherzer and they let Rendon go. They let, you know, they lost a lot of talent and then they decided to pay Strasburg 35 million. And he's pitched, I think, 4 1/3 innings since that World Series.
That was a stupid contract. The year they did have that World Series run, Strasburg was really good in the playoffs that year, I remember.
Yeah,
that was like a miracle almost because he's been hurt a lot throughout his whole career. So why throw him a contract after you've gotten the most out of him?
Right.
Like you'd think they would be smart enough to know, like, yeah, we got lucky with him there, but we don't need to sign him to a huge deal.
That year, had they gone out to get, like, because I feel like that year, too, like, in a way, financially, they were all in on shit, right? They had kind of gone out and gotten people like Kendricks or whatever that had a big World Series or whatever, that Howie Kendrick or whatever.
Yep.
Like, they had kind of paid, like, they kind of went out and paid, I thought, like, maybe not, but I think, Matt, their whole thing that year was they knew it was all, you know, we win it or we're going to not have these guys next year, no matter what. I think they knew Soto would, that the fucking dude that went to Rendon would be gone. Yeah. But yeah, the Strasburg, man, because he killed it and he looked like really good. And then they fell in love with him. If you're a Nats fan right
they still had Trey Turner at that time. You know what I mean?
So yeah, that's when I stacked. Yeah, they were ball. Yeah. Trey Turner is one of the better. I like that kid, man. I don't know how great of a year he's having right now, but I know that you bring up that shit and it's like, well, then if without being an asshole, I can just, I'll make fun. We won the World Series not too long ago, you know, the Red Sox.
But they didn't go to like the bottom of the division after that.
The next year?
Really?
Yeah, they've struggled pretty because everybody left.
Yeah, kinda, we weren't good in 19. We didn't have pitching. Yeah. Like, dude, the offense has been there. And we talked earlier this year in the podcast when the season started about, I was like, dude, I don't know what their plan is at pitching. I trust Bloom. You know what I mean? I hope I can. I don't know why, but I do. He built the Rays into a team with no payroll. So I guess his plan was like, well, I'll come to Boston. I'll get rid of every person that we do pay.
That's kind of his style.
We're going to have Michael Walk up. Yeah, dude, but it's a fucking mess in Boston.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on with that shit.
Yeah, well, I mean, back to the Soto thing, the Nats are trying to deal him now, basically, before the trade deadline.
Right.
And from the rumors I've come across, the two favorites are the Cardinals and the Padres. So, Brad, like, relating it to the Cardinals, would you want the Cards to give up a bunch of farm guys and a small piece or two to bring Soto in? Like, is that something the Cardinals need now? You know,
I think the Cardinals get attached to him because they'll never deny anything. So they're always a team that agents will like to attach a name to because they won't confirm or deny anything. They have the system, the farm club, but that's not a move the Cardinals make. You already are paying Goldschmidt and Arenado big money. They're not going to pay a third guy. That's just not their way.
He doesn't seem like a Cardinals guy. Like usually we sign the kind of like, not like super high tier, but a couple like high tier guys in free agency, like your Goldschmidts, Arenados. Back in the day, it was like Matt Holliday and Larry Walker.
Right.
You know, so they're never getting like the super, superstar. The Cardinals are just getting Reggie
Sanders,
high tier guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think Edgar
Renteria.
yeah. But you bring up a good point too, Brad, because like, dude, they don't want the teams thinking like the Cubs that like they're out on the guy because they want the Cubs thinking, man, we might have to make a play for them because the Cardinals do have a ton of young, good players right now, man. And like, if the Cubs, it'll be like, they would love for the Cubs to go overpay for the dude, give away all their farm just to have a name that they can get people to show back up to Wrigley again, because no one wants to go to those games right now, man. That team's brutal. So it's like a team like that, that would try to overpay for him. And I could see him at Wrigley. Like that is more, I could imagine that easier than I can at Busch Stadium. I would never see.
I think he ends up with the Dodgers.
Yeah. I mean, the Dodgers are willing to pay everybody.
They make, they have the farm talent to move him. I think that's what he ends up as a Dodger. I would almost bet.
There's a lot of drafts.
And then they win another World Series.
or two or three, you know, cause he's under control after this year for two more seasons until he's an unrestricted free agent. So he can still go to arbitration two more times.
But the new team would probably give him a new deal, right?
Probably.
Wouldn't that be how it would work out?
It just, whenever you're dealing with Scott Boras, you never really know. I mean, if he's turning down a 14-year 450, I mean, what's he asking for? Like 8 years, $500 million? I mean, nobody in baseball is getting paid 40-plus a year. It's just – it's going to be something crazy.
Whatever.
And honestly, we're talking about a guy that's hitting 248 this year.
Yeah, I'm not –
He's hit over 30 bombs once. He's hit over 95 ribbies one time.
I would take him – I would take – what he got. I mean, yeah, but if I was him too, I wouldn't have won a contract that long. I don't want to be locked into a deal that long. When you know you could go five to five and make more money or whatever, dude, like fuck that. And like you said too, dude, with a team like the Cardinals, if they are considered a front runner, it's like, dude, they already got Arenado and Goldschmidt, man. And they're having great, they're finally having years that like they should have had, like Goldschmidt should have had the whole time he's been.
Right.
So it, I don't think they don't need to be worried right now with the way their outfield is playing. And like with, and that's without fucking Beefcake out there playing that great. They have all the other.
Yeah.
And O'Neill.
Is that who you're talking about?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Beef. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah,
man. He kind of waddles around.
Let's talk a little bit more about the Cardinals. Cause I was looking at the numbers and nowadays, like people like, you know, your Otanis and your just home run hitters of the world, they're batting, like you said, like Soto is, they're averaging like 250. They're just hitting a lot of homers, batting a lot of runs in. Goldschmidt's batting 330 and putting up numbers. And like, why isn't he considered an MVP like Judge and Otani is? Because Goldschmidt has like the more impressive stat line when you look at all of it.
He's boring and he doesn't have a Twitter. But he is in Vegas, the front runner for MVP. Lives in,
like, not just NL MVP, but outright
now. There's only a NL and
right.
They don't give out a actual MVP.
No, it's NL and the AL MVP. I think that was always because of the DH too, which now that is weird kind of, but they don't just have one. But
that's why there was a separate distinction between the leagues.
I would think. Yeah. I'm
okay.
Yeah. But dude, that is, because he isn't outspoken. He plays for the Cardinals, man. You don't hear from him. Every player here is quiet. You know, like Adam Wainwright's the loud guy on
the team. The outspoken guy.
Yeah, that's like the guy that was like, oh man, you better watch out. Wayno might give you a swirly. Get the fuck out of here, man. Fucking nerd.
All right. Well, good. Any more like Brad, do the Cardinals have a chance for a World Series run? Do they have the bullpen they need to get through playoff series? Do they have everything?
Possible. I mean, they got to make a deal for a starting pitcher. They're relying on, I mean, Bueno's the ace. That's frightening. I mean, they're basically relying all on Miles Michaelis and Bueno. You know, and they're both like top 10 in innings pitched. They're both pitching well.
Could Shipman come back? Whatever.
Question I have. Carlos Martinez, the dude who like has sucked and like been from starter to bullpen, from bullpen to starter for years. Has that experiment have we given up? Like, is it done?
Oh, yeah.
We gave up on him.
Yeah.
They shipped him to Boston, man.
Oh, Boston tried about he could.
We hung on to Waka. We're like, fuck it. Yeah. All right, we'll take one of them, man. Yeah. Yeah,
okay. I don't think he's even in the league. I'm sure he's playing in like some Mexican league right now.
Okay, with Pablo. He had a promising first year, and then
he
was supposed to be so good, man. I don't know what happened. He got caught with a bunch of porn. You remember that?
Yeah,
he had all kinds of issues. He beat somebody up on a strip club. Yeah.
But on his phone, he had a bunch of he was like on his Twitter. He didn't know
20 like tabs open.
Other people, he
posted shit to Twitter, and
he was like favoriting shit on his Twitter, like retweeting it,
not knowing people could see it,
not knowing that it was so it was just like naked girls and shit, dude. And he's like, oh yeah,
you know, like, I want to save this for later.
Yeah, right. It's like, dude, yeah. When I get off work, I'm not pitching today,
but I got this shit right here.
He got his $50 million, and he checked the fuck.
That could have been part of his downfall, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I always felt bad because I knew he was close with Oscar Tavares.
The guy who passed away. Yeah, I remember.
And Jose Fernandez, the Marlins pitcher.
And
then the dude that was also Ventura or whatever that played for the Royals, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Whatever that dude's name was.
And that dude passed away too. Yeah. Car accident, something.
Yeah. Careful driving.
Yeah, man. It's a good spot to get your license at. Yeah. I mean, that's probably near the Philippines, no?
Let's move on to other darker news, Jimmy. The Red Sox. Because I had here when we were doing the outline for the podcast, I had included in there, this was like around the All-Star break, has the Red Sox bullpen gotten better? And then I go to checking some box scores from the last like week or two, and I see this series with the Blue Jays where they lose a game 28-5. So they gave up 4 touchdowns to the Blue Jays in that game. And then I checked back a little bit further. They gave up 14 runs and 13 runs to the Yankees in back-to-back games. So they're giving up like football scores to teams routinely. So the bullpen has not improved.
I think they're just getting excited at the NFL. I think that they're getting pumped up. The NFL's, you know, we're about to kick off too.
They need to see the double digits. They're trying to,
you're right. They're getting in that mojo of like, hey, let's match the Patriots.
Or their bullpen's like playing fantasy baseball and they're like, I'm going to pick up this guy off waivers that we're playing against today. And he's going to go off. Yeah. So it's been a good year for the Red Sox. They were trending upwards and it seems to have really just come to a crash landing here. The season might be toast. Do you feel like the season's done?
Are you aware that anything happened to Chris Sale at all?
Chris Sale.
You know,
were they really depending on him even at the beginning of the season? He wasn't healthy at the start of the season.
Expecting him back by round by or now. After the All-Star break. And then in your first start to fracture your pinky on a line drive. I mean, even the Yankees
in the dugout felt
bad for him even. You could see them all wincing and shaking their head.
Line drive off the hand, breaks his hand.
Yeah.
So you at me like an asshole.
Hey, they're still because the crazy that'd be thing
like
is
fucking Brady going down and me being card. Like, yeah, they're not. 49 we're not.
And 48. They're four. And
dude,
a half
we're
games
fine.
Out.
Look, put us in any other division. We're fighting at least for like somewhere it's in third or second. We it's play in the best pitching. Division maybe ever in sports, man. Like, really, I don't know, man. Yeah, I don't know what I mean. There's nothing to say. I knew the pitching was an issue, and I was worried about it the whole year. I was wondering which player we were going to have to lose. I still think that might happen. I'm hoping Bloom gets his head out of his ass and like knows what he's doing.
JD Martinez was rumored to be like a trade.
No, he definitely is. And like, dude, if that has to happen,
I think that'd be a great move for them.
It's a shame because like I thought this group. I remember watching when they beat the Dodgers in 18 and like they were so tight and like singing in the locker room, like, baby, lock the door and turn the latch down low. And it was like fucking Vasquez and Mitch Moreland, like two guys that you would never see, but they're like slow dancing together, like in the fucking locker room pouring champagne. And it was like, damn, they like are actually a close team. And now it's just fucking, I feel like there's just nothing, man. So if they have to blow it up, when Mookie Betts left, it really pissed me off. You knew that.
Yeah, and I mean, Bogarts, too, is probably one they let get out the door that might be – you don't like Bogarts?
I love Bogarts.
I've always liked his name.
I think I'd be shocked if they – I mean, he's a top five shortstop probably in baseball.
Amazing, dude.
You know, it's more – it's weird. You look at Xander and JD, and it's like they're both JD, over 300, but neither one of them even have 10 homers on the year. Like,
yeah, I don't know
what happened. Like, where's the power?
Yeah, I know.
You think of the Red Sox as just bombing the ball, and it's not there this year.
Yeah, especially in the stadium they play in. You think a guy like JD Martinez would have more than 10?
Well, and in that division, that's what plays in that division. You have to hit Daniel. Right. Like, you got to put up numbers and power numbers, especially. Like, you can't go into New York and think you're going to hit one dinger, like one homer the whole weekend. And you're going to have a good weekend in New York, like Toronto, like doesn't fucking matter. Yeah.
What the hell happened in that Toronto game? 28-5.
Yeah.
A lot of weird shit inside the park.
Yeah. There was an inside the park grand slam where our top prospect that like Brad kept saying like, when are they going to bring up Duran? When do they need him? Put him in the
I actually know him from baseball cards. I know that name, Duran.
He's coming in for the ball. He looks up at it and just starts trucking backwards after like a second because it's way over his head. And then he just stops and looks and the dude is cruising already past second base. Like,
was it Colby Rasmus who hit it?
Yeah. No, it might as well have been, dude. He would have, I mean.
You would have liked it. His name's Tapia. He's got real long dreads.
Stan Podolak from fucking Space Jam would have been able to. Yeah. Newman. He would have been able to score.
This is something like completely separate, but I do think it is a dude that plays for the Blue Jays. It's like a really short, chubby guy who like looks like he wouldn't be worth a shit.
Like their catcher, he'll play some DH.
I think so. He's like, he actually looks like a really fat, chubby guy.
Yeah.
But I heard he's actually pretty good.
Yeah. Alejandro Kirk, I think, or something like that. Yeah. He can hit.
Yeah.
But He is fat as fuck.
Yeah, it's just like you see that guy and you're like, God damn, how does somebody like that like make millions of dollars playing sports?
It was like Nick Punto.
Yeah.
Remember that name? I can't picture Nick Punto.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Little miniature Buddha.
Yeah.
little fucker.
Like this guy looks like an enlarged, like, you know, you see the people at the Little League World Series, like the fat kids that can just smack it.
Yeah.
But it makes sense in Little League, but it doesn't make sense that you could like grow into that and hold the same body type and make it work.
Who's the one guy? Vogelbach. Vogelbach, oh, big ass. That motherfucker, dude. Have you seen that cat?
No. Let me see if I can find
it. Vogelbach, dude.
Is it Vogelbach?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Not CK. It's an CH. He ate the K, so they replaced it.
The Mets just traded. So Kirk is 5'7", 245.
Job of the gut.
Yeah, so Vogelbach is that type of dude, too. I see this guy.
Yeah, man.
But he looks a little bit stronger than this guy I was thinking of.
The Kirk guy. Kirk shuffles around, doesn't move his
arm. Yeah, right. They do that little, Babe Ruth.
Yeah, it's this Kirk guy for the Blue Jays was who I was thinking about, though. That's just ridiculous. Like, he looks like he's 5'5", when you see him on a picture of him or see him on TV. About 300 pounds.
So the Blue Jays, I'm looking, they are like plus 1,500 on one, 1,520 on.
Yeah, because that's what we're getting into next is just kind of like sleeper teams we can find for the World Series to bet on.
Yeah.
So we can cancel out the favorites, which would be Yankees, Mets, Dodgers, and Astros.
Yeah.
Those have got to be the top four. And then sleepers I have in mind are like the Blue Jays you mentioned, the Padres, even though from what I hear they lack pitching a little bit. How do we feel about the Padres? I don't know if Tatis is hurt.
Well,
right
it's
now.
More they're pitching well, but the offense just can't hit.
Really?
I mean, it's Machado and nobody else right now.
Yeah. No Tatis still?
He's still messed up.
Motorcycle accident.
Yep. There was talk about trying to get fucking I heard something on it. It was probably just a rumor thing, but about Juan Soto, if they're like trying to get him out there.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't really trust the Padres, man. I don't know. I haven't, again, that's a bit like that's a team that I do not tune into. So I would not, I don't really watch a lot of Padres games. You know what I mean? The Red Sox are so good. It's kind of hard to watch any other team.
Yeah.
But another.
Go ahead. Throw it out there.
Seattle's been kind of fun to watch, man. I don't know, just because the Seahawks, I paid more attention to him because he's been into them lately, and they had that winning streak. Who else had the winning streak? What other team was that?
The Braves recently, maybe.
Yeah, that was the other. Yeah, okay,
they've been on a tear.
The Braves was the other team I was gonna bring up though, because you didn't say them as a favorite, right, or whatever. Like as one.
Yeah.
The Braves would be a team to watch, man, just because, like, I know. They lost Freeman or whatever, but I don't know, man. The way they're playing right now, and they all just have that, you know what I mean? They can all talk Indy. Like,
Albies, Acuna.
Yeah, they all got their own little language Ozuna. Going on. They're wearing the bright shit.
Wait, did he not get, suspended or arrested or something? Didn't he hit?
No, they found out that his wife beat him up worse than she beat him up worse than he beat her up, so it was like, they called it it was a draw. They're going to have a rematch at Caesars in Vegas.
Yeah, they're going to step into the ring.
Yeah, yeah.
Settle it there.
Joe Rogan's going to announce it. It's going to be bad.
Okay. All right.
I got 300 on his wife, Caitlin.
A few other teams. And let's run through this quick so we can get to the football. But the Twins, they're at the top of the AL Central. Any chance, or is it just kind of like they found a way to have a good regular season? Then they're not.
It's just
real,
a weak
really
division.
A
I think.
Yeah, it is a weak division.
Yeah, the Royals, the White Sox.
I like the Phillies.
Guardians.
I think the Phillies could make some something happen in the postseason.
I think Cleveland battles a little bit too. Like, I don't think.
Yeah.
I don't
Cleveland's
know.
Cleveland's only a few games back of them, but again, that's not a very good ball club either.
No, it's just in that division.
Yeah,
I'm
they
saying,
grind.
Because like that division's fucking weird, man. I thought the White Sox would be the good team there, and.
They had some hype before the season. I remember when we were talking, the White Sox were a potential
still there, breakout team.
Yeah. He's going to get scapegoated and probably fired. I don't know if he'll make the end of the season.
Scapegoated? The whole team hates him. What the fuck? I think that's called I think it's called the GM but, being like, all right, we hired
the. How much of not playing well on the field is the manager's fault, though?
Can you imagine, though, if he was the manager of a team like the Braves, like the way they are with their, like, how pissed he'd be on the bit, like, just like.
Yeah, I haven't paid attention like Marv. I wonder if he's lightened up at all. I doubt it, but.
No,
You think he's eased up on the drinking at all?
Oh no, he loves his wine too much. He just really got a driver.
You guys probably heard more stories than I did about like people seeing La Russa in bars, like before, even like before games, and he would just be throwing them back at a bar.
I didn't know that. I just know all the D-dub stories.
Yeah, I mean, there's those too. But when I would even hear people from like stories from people personally about like, oh. It was like 2 hours before first pitch, and I saw La Russa at the fucking bar.
Because he knows he's penciling in Skip Schumacher at second base. He's like,
better drink then.
And then they're going to win a World Series because anytime they have a bad, But you asked if he's drinking, looking at the 48-48 record on July 26th. He's drinking, man, guaranteed. You know, there's no way he made it this long this season without having a couple.
Right. Yeah. 48. And I mean, once you get old, what else is there to fucking do except for drink? You know?
Yeah.
I mean, I found that, but I'm 30 and I've almost gotten to that point already. Yeah.
Dude. But, it's just frustrating when I look at some of these teams because, like, the Detroit has 39 wins and they shouldn't even be like have any. It's like, dude, if they were in the AL East, that team might have 15 wins. You know what I mean? Like some of those teams in that division are so bad, man. Like I can't name half the players on Cleveland and they're in second place right now.
Yeah. What about what I was curious at looking at the standings just because it surprised me was the Orioles being like, I know they're at the bottom of the AL East, but they're right there with the Sox, you know, like they are right there.
But they just said that was the other team, not the Braves. The Orioles had like a 13 game win streak right before the All-Star break. Yeah. Just looking at the numbers, I forgot about it because it was like, it didn't even really, that's what doing that in that division does for you, dude. It's like, wow, you kept pace. Congratulations.
Right. Now they look like assholes when they sell off all their best players.
Yeah, now their fans are going to want to kill him. Yeah, it's sad. And it really is because baseball is like that too. It's like, yeah.
Well, we have those teams in football too. You know, like the Texans are probably never going to really turn it around. What's another team with shitty ownership? The Bengals have shitty ownership and somehow had a lucky season last year. Like they've notoriously, the Bengals have been known to have shitty ownership and they just got lucky on enough draft picks to have
the Commanders.
Yeah. You know, it's amazing what,
the Commanders have the shittiest for your ownership. Franchise.
I watched a video
in Jacksonville.
Dude, I watched a video in the Commander on their stadium in Washington, D.C. And there's fans sitting there literally getting dripped on
with shit
in a box with shit. Like they're in a box fucking booth and they left the booth and are sitting in the normal stands because like that's where our box was and it's just a leaking plumbing pipe right above them and there's it's like that's incredible.
That's probably the worst owner.
I'd say Dan Snyder's the worst
going
owner,
to prison.
The Jags are close though because they seem to Kroenke's more focused on the wrestling and whatever else that con dude gets his money from.
Yeah.
He just wanted to own a team. He doesn't really give a fuck how they do.
This loopy mustache, man.
Hey,
if you're gonna be a douchebag, you should look like that.
Yeah,
like,
just have a decent mustache.
You like better do it right.
Go all in.
A villainous mustache.
You're villain, dude. Yes, exactly. Some kind of fucking 1776 bullshit, dude. All right.
Let's get into some serious football take in a minute. Let's take a 5-minute break just so we have time to actually get through all the football stuff. We'll come back part two. We'll hit the trivia and then we'll do all football talk after the trivia in part two.
Because we got to talk a little why the Chiefs are going to only have their over under on wins will be 9.5 this year, and I'm going under.
Potential.
They will not have Chiefs, 11 wins this year.
Potentially bottom of the division for the Chiefs.
Potentially.
Hey, if they're left tackle,
no, the Raiders are looking fine. They're going to fuck up. They're going to be down there. The Chiefs will be a little hot. I don't know, man.
It's tough. You could make an argument for any team in the AFC West to finish at the bottom of that division.
We got five left. There, let's have a little conversation.
Yeah, you want to just do AFC West?
A little quick combo.
Let's all rank them 1 to 4 in the AFC West. Because I'll just fire it off real quick. I'm going to go Chargers 1, Chiefs 2, Raiders 3, Broncos 4.
Is that just a fuck with
that's
me?
That's just Mahomes going 2. That's how that much just, I believe in Mahomes.
Is that just a fuck with me?
No, because I just like how the Raiders have done this offseason. When you think about having Waller, Adams,
Russell Wilson is the second best quarterback in that division.
No, Herbert is.
Yes. No.
Herbert is.
No, you're wrong. No.
You know, I'm a Herbert fanboy, dude.
It's factually
inaccurate.
I got to
put Chargers at the top of that division.
It's factually
I'm a Herbert fanboy. Mm. All right, you do your top four. I'm going to note this so just we can recollect this in January.
Chargers, Broncos, Chiefs, Raiders. I think that's what it'll be at the end of the season. I think the Broncos barely edge them out. I just think we're a little bit better.
Do two or three teams make the playoffs out of that?
I think three
Chargers,
make
Broncos.
The playoffs out of
so
that.
So you got Chargers, Broncos, Chiefs making the playoffs.
Yeah. Because I think the like Pittsburgh, that division, normally you get it like at least, what, two out of there, I guess you would say, right? Like, and they might only get one.
You know, with Cleveland,
yeah,
and
but you never
the way
know. I don't know.
This year, I almost write those two off.
Either one of them are off. Yeah, yeah.
But we'll stay in this division.
I think
Brad. What about you? Like the only kind of unbiased, like completely unbiased person in this division.
I mean, if Trent Brown doesn't get to training camp, I'm gonna go Chargers, Raiders, Broncos, Chiefs.
I think Orlando Brown. Yeah, Orlando Brown, not Trent. Yeah. Yeah. Chargers, Raiders, Broncos, Chiefs. And what about you as far as like three teams making the playoffs?
Because it's not going to come from the fucking AFC North.
I'm going to say two teams just because I think somebody's going to get lucky in a weaker division. I see just beating the shit out of each other all year.
Yeah. And then you almost have to figure at least two out of the AFC North get spots, right? Bengals, Browns, Ravens.
Right. That's
at least two of those three are getting spots. Keep in mind, we do have three wild cards nowadays.
Right.
So
I'll say I think the Broncos squeak in with the last seed.
Squeak in.
Well, yeah, that would just the being oh, in that division at what happens. You know, it's
Yeah. Just you know what I mean.
I just think they're about a year
away. If you
woke
up tomorrow,
really taking off. I think those receivers with Russ in a year from now, it will be different.
If you woke up tomorrow and were told you could have Russell Wilson, would you keep Lamar Jackson as a Ravens?
100%.
Yeah.
Really.
Right now you would. Right now you would. Russell's had a couple. Russell's had a couple bad games. Russell's had a couple bad years though here. And like not all his
fault. With a bad O line. I mean, terrible. Dude,
but when you're watching a bad Russell Wilson game, you're just looking there with like open palms. Like, what the hell are you thinking, Russ? Because he'll run around back there until he gets sacked.
Yeah, 100%. I'd take Lamar over Russ.
All right, that's
especially when you think long term too. You know, I'm taking agent.
No, I asked if you woke up tomorrow, given the guys that you would get. Yeah,
but I'd say next season I'd rather have Lamar than Russ.
Yeah, that's fair. I wanted to know.
It is an argument, you know. Yeah, it's close.
I disagree, but I'm not just saying that just because I don't trust Lamar.
They're both asked to do a lot in their offense, just completely different ways of doing it.
Yeah,
I think Lamar's trending down, but we'll see.
All right, we'll talk more football in a little bit. Let's take
either way.
I do got those.
The
early AFC West prediction.
Hey, I was the only one that had
him
fourth, right?
He had him third. Did Matt have him second?
I actually had him second just because I think Mahomes will find a way to make it happen.
Yeah.
But we'll see. I have my legitimate concerns about the Chiefs. I don't think they're going to have an outstanding year.
Oh, they're fucked.
Yeah. I think the Chargers are the cream of the crop. in that division.
Yeah, all right. Cheers. We'll be back.
Right. Get Eckler, get tired, boys.
All right. Cheers. Word.